This video we will see how to create a Spring Boot application or project by using a Spring Tool Suite, which is one of the most important and very useful IDE for developing Spring Boot application, because there are many other IDEs also available in the market like Eclipse. This IDE also based on Eclipse only, and IntelliJ, many more. But this STS is providing a lot of built-in features to develop the Spring Boot application in faster way. That's why most of the people use this STS as a IDE for Spring Boot application development. Okay, let's start creating application by using this. Okay, so first file, new, and Spring Starter Project. Just click on this one, where we will see this one. It will ask the details about our project. Depends upon our project, we will provide the project name. What is the project name? Here, this is just a demo purpose, right? I am giving some Spring Boot app with STS demo, like that. And type, there are it supposed to supports two type of projects. One is Maven project, another one is Gradle. Gradle also different versions are there, so I use so Maven only. So packaging, we can whatever we want. That is also purely depends upon our project, how we are going to develop that one. There are two types of packagings, one is jar and var. We will see in depth details about these things in later videos. Okay, as of now I am selecting jar and Java versions also. So depends upon the project requirement. So what are the features we want, those things we will use, right? Generally Java 8, I'm selecting Java 8 only. Language is Java. So here group, we have to provide the group ID, artifact ID, version of our project. Okay, description, whatever it may be, like it is there already, java.hangout, which is group ID, and artifact ID is by default it will come, like whatever we give here, Spring Boot app with STS demo, right? Same thing is here. So version, this is also auto generated one. If you want, you can change. Some people we use based on release name and versions, release name, versions, different environments also, testing environment, development environment, testing environment, and LUAT will be there, NFT later, production, right? Based on that environment, they will use environment name and versions. Description, whether it is a banking project, retail project, whatever it may be, like this is the package. Okay, that's it. This is an important thing, and where we can select the dependencies for our development. So Spring Web is to develop the RESTful web service by using Spring Boot, right? This is one. And Dev Tools, it is very very important dependency for a Spring Boot application. So which will like actuators are there, right? So by using actuator is one of the important feature of Spring Boot. We will discuss about Spring components later. Okay, then finish it. Yes, it's imported. We gave, right, a Spring Boot app with STS demo. See, SRC main Java, SRC main resource, SRC test Java. So in SRC main Java, so this is the package we provided, com.javahangout.jh.sb. Shortcuts, and by default whatever project name is there, like a Spring Boot app with STS demo, and it will append application. That's it. It will give a Spring Boot class. So this is the by default generated by IDE. Okay, so this is the entry point for any Spring Boot application. application. It is generated successfully, and this is the version what we selected 1.8. So and pom.xml, we can see all dependencies whatever we selected during this creation of application. Okay, here parent dependency is the very 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 important topic in Spring Boot, because this version, whatever version is there, right, it represents the Spring release version 2.3.0 what we selected while creating this project. So based on this all dependency versions will be imported. We selected spring-boot-starter-web, right? We are not providing any version, because the Spring Boot automatically take care of other dependency versions based on this version. Okay, parent in easy way, parent dependency version depends upon the parent dependency version. So other dependency is versions will be imported. Yeah. This is all about pom.xml. We will discuss more deeply in later videos. Okay, now this is the initial entry point for application. We'll see. And one more thing is src main resources. Here static folder is template is there, application.properties. application.properties is very very important. We can use application.aml file or properties, that is our wish. So this property file is important, where we will provide all the properties key and value pair to the our application. So for example, this application will run on embedded Tomcat server, so which will run on port number 8080 by default. We can change that port number here. How? Server dot port, it will give all the options whatever available. See, server dot port, we can by default port number is 8080. We can change whatever we want to 8989 also. Save it and go back to this main application file. This is Spring Boot app with HTS demo application. Right click on this one, run as. There are many three options are there: Java application, Spring Boot app. Just click on Spring Boot app. We can see, yes, see Tomcat started on port number 8989. By default it will start on port number 8080, but we changed in the property file, we provided a custom port, that is 8989. That's why this application is started on 8989. Okay, so started a Spring Boot app with HTS demo application in 1 seconds. Also, how much time it took to come up the application. This is how we can define the Spring Boot applications by using HTS IDE. Thanks for watching video. If you are not yet subscribed to this channel, please subscribe it now for more updates. Thank you.